Welcome back to This Practice Update. I'm your host, Dr. Prasanna Hafazullah. Joining me today, Dr. Timothy Plouard. Excellent to have you back.
Glad to be here.
So let's talk a little bit about the study that you're involved in, looking at the wanting to increase lung cancer screening. Why do you think it's important to actually screen for lung cancer?
Well, we have the data
Yes.
that shows that screening can reduce mortality from lung cancer. The challenge has been to really implement that in the daily practice of general practitioners and primary care doctors. And so within our health system, we underwent a process of implementing this through our electronic medical record so that we would automatically identify those patients at the point of contact with their primary care, and then had an electronic process to facilitate the shared decision making that's mandated by CMS, and then to go ahead and order the test. And we've seen with implementing that in just a pilot population of about 20 primary care docs that we've seen a substantial increase in the number of lung cancer screening exams taking place and identification of some early stage lung cancers. So we're now expanding that to go across several hundred primary care physicians and see if it can be scaled effectively.
Well, can you tell us a little bit more about this electronic medical records-based application, how it's exactly designed to work?
So part of the initial process that was to make sure that we had appropriate data, because while we often see smoking status in the electronic medical record, for purposes of screening, it really needs to be quantified
Yes.
as to how long they smoked, how much they smoked, current versus when they quit. And so training the actual staff to enter the data when they're rooming patients was the first hurdle that we had to get through. Once we got through that, then if the patient meets criteria, it automatically fires an alert to the doctor at the time he's seeing the patient, and then he can lead the patient through the process of undergoing the lung cancer screening and whether they would like to proceed, and then it generates the order for the lung cancer screening scan.
Fantastic. Sounds like an amazing clinical decision tool.
It's been very effective.
Yes. You alluded to widespread application. Can you tell us some of the challenges that you might face with widespread application of a tool like this?
I think it's going to require training mm-hmm. of the staff. I mean,
yes.
I think that to get the appropriate data in so that you can actually deliver the alert to the physician at the point of care is going to be the biggest challenge and hurdle.
Well, we want to thank you very much for highlighting this very important attempt here and this screening methodology that you're using for lung cancer. We appreciate that work, and we're happy to have you here on Practice Update.
Thank you.
And to our viewers, thank you again for joining us for this Practice Update. I'm Dr. Hafazullah. Join us again soon.